In today's video, we're going to do a product test. Now here in New England at the end of the season, our beds start to look really worn out and tired. The mulch just gets dried out from the heat and the rain, and it just looks nothing like it did when it first went down. And for years I've seen this product called mulch paint, and I really wondered if it actually would work, and I thought this was a good year to put it to the test because we've had a ton of heat and the mulch is just cooked. So we're going to show you how to use this product, how it goes down, and most importantly, what the results are, and you can judge for yourself if it's something you want to try in your own yard. Now, I was very skeptical as I started this because products like this tend to be gimmicky and they don't always do what they say they're going to, so I figured I'd give it a shot, follow the directions, and see how we end up. This product is made by MulchWorx and it's called Brown Mulch Colorant. Now, they also offer it in black and red, but I picked this brown because I thought it would match what I already had. And this is a regular, inexpensive 2-gallon garden sprayer. I was very nervous about using my battery-powered one in case the cleanup on this thing was a disaster. And the directions say to use between 2 and 5 ounces per gallon, so I decided to kind of split it a little bit and I used 4 ounces per gallon, so a total of 8 ounces. And now I'm just going to add in another 4 ounces and we'll be all set to pump up the sprayer and give it a shot. And I spilled a little on the side of the sprayer, so I decided to kind of rinse it off into the sprayer so that I didn't get the dye all over the place. Now with our dye in there, I'm just going to close this up, give it a couple of shakes, and we should be ready to start spraying. Almost all these sprayers are going to include a few different tips that you can use with it, and what I did was I used the largest tip that they included that's a fan-style nozzle, and all that means is that when it sprays it out, instead of just being a round pattern, it's kind of like a line, and that became really handy because as I got near the plants or near the edge of the grass, it made it easy for me to cut the dye in. So this way I didn't spray the dye onto the grass and I didn't need to mess with any kind of cardboard shield because that kind of thing was just going to make this a real pain in the butt to do and I just wanted this to be quick and easy and that was the whole point of using a product like this, that it should be simple. Now I'm just going around and spraying obviously the whole bed. You can see already the difference in color, but the one thing that was starting to stand out to me was it looked very red to me. So as I was putting this down, I got a little bit nervous because the color I really wanted was dark brown and not a bright type of red. Now keep in mind this product is totally non-toxic, it's safe, it can wash into the environment or anywhere and it's not going to cause any kind of a problem, so I really didn't have any qualms about using it, but again what was starting to get to me as I was spraying it was I just didn't like the color, it looked very bright red to me, so I was getting very nervous but I decided to just keep spraying and do the whole job and see how it turned out. The directions say that you're supposed to spray multiple coats. To be honest, I didn't really want to get into that, so I just put down one heavier coat. But this is what it ended up looking like, and I was very surprised because this wasn't really the color that I wanted. It looked very bright red to me. So I was pretty upset because I had spent some time doing this, but then I waited a little bit and I did some other things, and when I came back about a half an hour, maybe 45 minutes later, the color changed a lot and it turned into this. So I was very surprised by what happened and I can't really explain what took place, but it must just be the setup of the dye or maybe it just soaked into the existing mulch. But I was much happier with the way this looked and this was really the color I wanted. And compared to the untreated part, you can see a big difference. And this product really surprised me. I never thought this was even going to work, nevertheless looked pretty good. So considering I didn't have to put down new mulch, it wasn't a lot of money, and it only took about 20 minutes with a regular sprayer, the end result was actually very good. But the one thing that was left that I was dreading was the cleanup. But to my surprise, once I opened this sprayer up and I started to wash it off, everything just came off. And I guess that's because until it dries, it's very easy and it's totally water soluble. So this thing cleaned up faster than most other products I used. It didn't stain the grass and it really did fine. So I was very surprised with this product. I never thought it would work this well. It made the beds look better. It was easy to apply. It's safe and it's quick to do. So if you want to dress up your beds and enjoy a little bit more time in the season without spending any money on mulch, this is a great option. So hopefully this video showed you a product you may not have seen before, and if you liked it, please give me a thumbs up, comment below, and subscribe to my channel if you're not already for more videos coming up.